Okay, I'm on it. We're streaming.
Smile, you're on camera.
I'm actually gonna leave some space so that we can do our maneuvers.
Let's do like 70 knots.
Stormrend is holding at HP Jack.
Storm, you pick up. Paladin 4 is your call sign.
Copy that, Paladin 4.
Alright, I got visual on our building. I'm gonna take a wide hook.
Copy. Sorry, I meant 2.
I'll lay down a fourth building for you, wait until Paladin 4 and get on it. Time now 16:42.
Alright, we'll go back to the HP and start over fresh. That looks pretty good. Stevia, yours look good. 3, I'd try and get in a little tighter.
3 copies.
Try and aim for 10 to 15 seconds. Landings or hoverings, I guess.
I was really playing catch up. I missed half of it when I was coming back in. I just kind of followed your lead in there.
Hey, Bradley, did you hear what I said, by the way?
Roof 4 is on the map, Mark. Roof 4.
Copy that, Roof 4. Are we doing fast rope hovers or are we landing?
Just getting the hovers on there, Storm. No landing, just kind of in formation at this point, trying to do TOTs.
Copy.
User joined your channel.
Who are you asking?
Name you're ready, Wade.
Alright, everyone formed up?
Quick question before we go.
Go ahead.
Is the numbers going to change since there's 4 now?
No, Storm will just pick up the 4 spot.
Be advised, I also have a tag along in my bird.
Who is it?
Apparently Hatch got in on the gunner seat as I was about to take off. I didn't even know he was here.
Nice. I'll pull him out of there.
Alright, so we'll do the basically same thing as last time.
Never mind, let him stay if you don't want to let him watch.
I'll take the 4 roof, CVA take
Roger
two,
that.
Deckers 2, Storm you take 1.
Take rooftop 1.
Yeah, we're going to come in, we're going to do sort of a wide right hook in, as you can see on the map, and then we're going to each branch off to our building. Everyone tracking?
Yeah, 3 copies. You said roof 2 for Decker.
Yep. Alright, we're gonna fly in about 70 knots, and then once we enter the hook, we'll sort of lead off from there, but yeah, try and keep it tight. Remember, 10 to 15 second spacing. Alright, one's coming in. Not 184. Moving into the hook.
Too quick.
Wind speed.
Set.
4 set.
Okay, I'm gonna play the part north.
That did look good, Wade. That's a good job.
Use back information.
3.
4.
I think 3 is, do that J-hook just a little bit faster, you'll be on the building in a little bit quicker time.
Recoveries.
Don't worry, 3, it takes time. Mine was absolute dog shit right there.
I just misjudged it off the first one. I tried to do the same thing I did first time.
2 flare.
3 flare.
4.
Alright, hold it here. Put Pro in the getting formation.
I'm gonna put down quick to let Hatch get out of the gunner seat and up somewhere where he can see what we're doing.
Alright, what's next, Burberry?
Well, I wanted to do this for a little time. Do you want to do, I'll take the buildings away and we'll do some ground landings here for a couple of trips, just get the reps in, and then I think we're going to move over to cargo drops with fixed wing.
Sure.
I'll start setting up everything.
I'll remove these buildings except for one, and we'll just have you land on the road next to one in between the control tower and this original building.
Hello.
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 How's it going? How are you?
We have come. Let's search for the Holy Grail. I got one. Anyway.
Four is back in line.
So I think they're going to be moving their, doing their exercise real quick. I think they're going to need a couple of helicopters.
Okay.
For the air assault.
So they want us to help out with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
HLZ Dusk.
Bradbury, you good with that, or do you want to tell them
that
to
road
TP?
Right there?
Yeah, I'll have them report in to give me a hold point, and I'll have them report in to Doom.
So, yeah, so Dalton will be running with you guys. He'll be planning everything out for you guys.
Okay.
My recommendation, so you guys don't waste your time, because it's probably going to take them a minute to clear out this whole area. For, like, the transport helicopters, you drop them off, let them do their, and then go back to training for however long you guys want to. Like, a couple, like, three or four clicks away so they can stay nearby. And then once you guys get the call back from Dalton, you guys won't be far away.
All right.
Yeah. But just for your SA, they probably will be there for a minute, so you will have time on your hands to do whatever you guys feel the need to do.
Sounds good.
Hey, Paladin 1, HLZ Alpha is on the road right there. You'll have your landing right there.
All right. I'll tell Dalton to get in touch with you.
How many pilots do we have, Bradbury?
Air, this is Doom 1-1.
Oh, there he goes.
All right. Doom 1-1, this is Air.
Hey, will you guys be ready to step off in 15, Mike?
Roger that. Just give me a hold point, and we'll have a four bird your way.
Say again?
26.
Just give me a hold point.
Copy that.
You want to do six?
Yeah, we can do six.
Okay. You want to ask him to put down two extra HLSs?
Doom 1-1, this is Night Stalker.
Go for Doom.
Roger that. Give me two more HLSs in your patterns. Give me six total birds.
Copy that. We're going to RTB re-kit, and then I'll talk to you guys there.
Roger that. Just let us know. Paladin 1, after this, I'll be picking up Paladin 6, and the CO will be Paladin 5.
Roger. All right, everyone, check the map. Just gonna come in nice and easy. Nice little hook there, and then come in. Same order. Any questions? All right, cool. All right. One is stepping up.
Birds are downstairs.
Cool.
About
7-1. Yeah, we'll get behind them on the start up here. Paladin 1, once you're down on the ground, just hold your HLZ until 5 or 6 are in formation.
Yeah, that was good, right? check our bath out to the left. We're not cooler side of that.
Four is down.
Roger, want to make sure everybody's on their aircraft long ranges.
How to fly sound off.
Four.
Your 6 is in formation, you have a flight. We got about 15 mics for this first HLZ. Let's do some formation flying the trail and then do a random 2 LZs or something.
Say again, speed.
7-5.
Copy, 7-5.
Hey, Paladin 1, this is 6. When Doom 1-1 calls us up on 7-0, you'll be the one answering.
Someone call for Doom on this net.
Roger, Doom, when you're ready, call a Paladin flight for your
copy that, Paladin flight.
Still maintaining 75.
Oh, we're up to 90.
4.
Why does it do?
Go ahead, dude.
Expect 7 mics for step off and see when ready for the LZ brief.
Roger, go ahead.
So we're gonna be a Salty Panichori on the southwest side of the map. HLZ Dusk. I drew you a nice little arrow from what we want you to come in from, but come in from the southeast, egress to the south. And expect 28 souls.
Pick up the dawn sunlight.
I'll see dusk.
Yes.
Hey, firm. Ignore that the other one. It's the one to the further west.
I'm doing 95 and they're still pulling away. Last I knew we were doing 90.
Yeah, I'm doing 100, sorry. Not the map. Yeah, we're going 100, 245. So did you want to cut down a few birds or?
Bring them all in and give them a
shot. Wait, if you land them up parallel with the runway next to their spawn, which is
pretty good.
Say again. South to north, or north to south, next to the spawn.
Want to go back to base?
I think it's picking up from it. I think we're taking
well,
to that.
I was gonna say your flight lead, contact Doom and double check with him. I'd rather you double check than all of us, you know, get it wrong because we were guessing back and forth.
Go for Doom.
Where is the pick location for Ben?
Main base.
Hey, Ben. Alright. Just saying north to south, you want to do?
Just suggestion. It's up to you and what you want to do. Call it out.
What's your speed?
95. We're turning in. We're about 90. Heading up.
And Paladin, expect this to be at night as well.
Hey, Alright, we'll come in sort of north-south.
This is 6. Advise him not to change it tonight until we're on the ground.
This is out of flight. Be advised. Wait until we land before changing the conversation.
Copy that, I'll let you even know.
Six is clear of the active one. Flight's in the deck.
Four has cleared the runway. Up a little more there, three.
Three on the deck.
Four.
Hey, Paladin, are these birds in number order for takeoff? Copy, further northeast.
Six is down, one.
Yeah, that's how we did it, is checkpoints are things of note, so not necessarily turns, but like a power line would be a checkpoint. whereas waypoints break up the long distance so we can do things like speed checks, altitude checks, bearing checks.
Hey Novix, what bird are you in?
Bird 5.
Bird 5, copy. Me and Geneva are going to come with you.
Copy.
You good, Trevor?
Excuse me. Be advised, it looked like one of those tried to board incorrectly. Like you may hit your rotor. You have him
again. He hit my rotor?
It appears to be a decent maybe, but just want to check it out.
Copy. I'm not getting any warnings.
Gotcha.
Is Geneva on board? Is Geneva on board?
Are you ready to go?
Yeah, I'm on board.
Yes, sir.
Everybody loaded in?
Four.
Five.
All in.
Six is loaded up, ready to
Don't
go.
Don't let them know we're good.
And Paladin, good for takeoff.
Copy. Counter flight. Yep.
Hey, make sure you have guys on the guns. Guys that are responsible.
Probably 5 minutes.
How do you power on the minigun?
Don't worry about it.
Well, I'd like to know just to know. I'm a man of knowledge.
6 ready for departure.
Yeah, sorry, trying to explain something to Hatch here.
Okay, 5.
Okay. Hey Google.
Yeah, doing good.
How do you power on board on the right on armor 3?
Copy.
Door gun. Power on,
door
gunner, helicopter,
4, 5, 6,
show on 4 clicks.
Power line just ahead of CP6.
Yeah. 4.
5.
6 copies fine.
Hey, make sure you SLs turn on your strobes.
Train on your left too.
One bleeding speed.
Once we get on the ground.
5 bleeding.
You doing okay? 5, be aware of 4 crossing back.
Copy.
Sir, I'm trying to multitask and explain things.
Roger that.
Is on deck.
One's all out.
Six is down.
Four is clean. Four is up.
Five is up.
Six is there. One. Six feet wet.
Roger.
One, this is six to find us a spot to land, and we'll do a short little debrief on this LZ. Comes from.
Give it a little bit of cyclic, the opposite direction that you're rolling, see if that helps.
Bradbury, there's Sixers power lines are for me.
Four is down.
Actually got the power line, so hold the performing bond. Down,
Everybody here?
How bad was it?
Oh, I think it looked pretty good. We just got to remember that if we're flying, we're doing three things. We're aviating, navigating, and communicating, and in that order. So aviating is flying the bird first. Navigating is following your checkpoint second. Third is communication. So I think that we can remember those three items and kind of clean up the way things kind of act. So if we're primarily focused is to stop talking, stop worrying about waypoints, and fly the bird, less proponent of accidents will happen. The second thing we'll throw in there is then we're following our waypoints and getting to our HLSs. That'll be...
Doing this as a Paladin flight, send it.
Are we playing on any fixed wing tonight, or just the Paladin flight?
Stand by.
Just Paladin.
Got it.
Give that question to Novus.
Just Paladin.
Just Paladins?
Yep.
Jim, that'll just be Paladins, no fixed wing.
Copy, just Paladin. And at the moment, expect the same LZ for reinserts.
Roger.
But other than that, I think it was a good job. Novix, have you got any comment?
Yeah, Storm is teaching while flying, and I noticed that you fly a little high, and you vary your speed a lot, therefore the chain has to do the same behind you.
Mm-hmm.
So while you're teaching, so I don't know if you want to do less teaching, more flying, or...
Well, I mean, it's something I need to practice is, you know, doing that level of multitasking.
Yeah, usually the teacher's up front so that they kind of set the tone, but...
I think I can do fine. Yeah, I was a bit high and whatnot, and I'll work on that.
Storm, you got anything then?
I was gonna say I think it would help if we got better updates sometimes when you change the speed, because there were times I would hold right at what you said last time, and then I'd catch up to three, and then there were times when I'd be holding at what you set, and three would pull, forever away from me.
Good stuff. I would also like to ask if you guys are, and this is for everyone, except for flight lead. Flight lead's responsibilities are going to be maintaining altitude and airspeed and heading, and then reporting that to the flight. So he's really saying, hey, I'm going 90 at 360, at 100 feet, and then the rest of you guys are going to be like, 1, 2, 3, and so on and so forth. Keep your eyes on the aircraft in front of you and just check back glance, hot glance your HMD. You're not going to focus on it. It's not your primary thing in these flights. Also, I noticed that we were trying to line directly up to, so desync on these things will happen to us and we can crash. So it's okay to go left and right of that solid line and trail, okay? Wade, you are our newest master aviator. Have you anything to add?
I thought it looked good. Flying.
I think you're in whisper, Wade.
Overall, I thought it looked pretty good. I thought we run into some trouble with the LZ fitting all those birds in, but was no trouble really.
Cool.
I wasn't really watching the flying. I was trying to stay focused on where I was going.
No, and everybody here to realize too, Wade is one of our instructor pilots. So Hatch and Decker, communicate with him next week to line up at least 1 hour of flight time, each of you on his schedule. Okay? Send those out early, say like Monday, say I can be on Thursday or I can be on Saturday or whatever the case is, and see if we can't match up with him, so that you get some extra pointers from what else you're learning currently. Decker, that's going to be especially proponent with you because we're really going to step you up now.
Roger.
All right, then.
Hatch, we're going to go through. You're going to just mirror what Decker just got done with, so we've got that fresh in our minds, and we'll have you ready in about a week and a half.
All right, then.
Yeah, so far I'm just talking to him about, I was just talking to him about, the symbology and stuff, to help aid keeping speed, altitude, and all that stuff.
Yeah, every little tidbit you can throw at him at this point is going to be something that he'll remember. It may not be today. It may be a month from now. He'll say, oh, I remember hearing that before. So right now they're just going to be feeding from the fire hose, and hopefully we don't squirt too much out, you know?
It's a little intense for the pilots coming in at night, especially if it's weather and trying to make sure everybody's in sync and watching the altitude. And then on top of that, we throw a little fire at you, and then it seems like everybody just either
shuts themselves the fuck down.
Yeah, they shut down, not thinking. So
you're gonna get zapped so many times.
I told Hatch this. I want to make sure that it is still a thing to keep in mind, and that we didn't come up with a solution for it, but got to make sure that you don't have AFM guys flying with standard guys, because it, you know, fucks shit up.
I think your cat's in heat.
I think the cat has an issue. The cat, something's wrong with the cat, Storm.
Yeah, no, she just went into heat like 3 days ago, so I have a week and a half left of this.
It doesn't like what you're doing to it.
I actually think her problem is more I'm not doing the things she wants me to do.
Yeah.
Like, I had to swat her.
No, stop.
I had to swat her away because she was trying to play stripper on my computer.
Wait, what
oh
now?
My God, call Pita.
Well, now that we got that, I have a quick question.
Okay.
And it has nothing to do with cats.
Thank God.
She's looking at you guys now that you're talking about her.
Yeah. Go ahead, Decker.
During that LZ, the spots are in there, obviously, when we touch down. As long as everybody's, you know, in the grid area of the LZ location. And I just flew in there and found space because I, like you said, Bradbury, I was flying solely off Cedia because he was two, so I was just watching where he was, and that's how, if I go forward faster, go slower, go faster, go slower.
So here's some things to keep in mind when you're coming to these LZs. Your little map marker is going to be there in your HUD, and you're going to kind of be focused on beginning my flare at this point and slowing down here. If I have to kick it sideways real quick to get a little extra braking, I can do that. But don't forget, look out on the ground for the little shrubs, because this fucking map's full of them. These little cattails you see, you can fly right through. But these little shrubs that are off to our left and right in front of us, those fucking things will take you out. So
they're made of landmines,
yeah,
in case you're
exactly
confused.
And
yeah, they're right
sometimes,
over there.
Sometimes they don't fucking pop up until you're like right on top of them. They're like ghosts out here. So watch that. The little rock balls, they will fuck your fuselage up in a second. Watch it. And the guys exiting your helicopter, I don't know how we keep doing this, but they run into rotors. I watched one hit Novix's rotor a minute ago. I was like, how in the fuck are we still doing this? But yeah, so there's lots to watch out for.
Something that I don't know if like other people have been doing or whatnot, but just to help out, when we get told we're going to go somewhere like this LZ there, before we ever took off, or heck, even if you get yourself stable and just in a flat flight, pull up your C-tab, place down the little personal marker on it, and you will physically be able to see that with your HUD. It'll not only tell you how far away you are, but it will tell you how long it's taking you at your current speed to get there. And that's how we can better do things like time on targets, as well as when we're all coming in a cold, dark place, you need to try to land as close to your spot as possible, because especially when Pathfinder gets kicked up, that spot could be the safe spot in a dangerous area that was mapped out prior.
I actually gotta go right now. Dinner's ready, so I will see you guys later.
Sounds good.
Hatch, I need a time from you. PM me about when we can start your flight training, and I need to do that in the next couple days.
All right.
Thank you. Wade, anything to add on the LZ lookout fours?
I'd say just situational awareness, especially these sort of tight LZs with a lot of birds. Because obviously you want to get down safely, but equally important is that the person behind you or in front of you has enough space so that they can come in and land where it's supposed to. So if you're, I mean, it's good that you get down, but if you just like find a spot of grass and set down, you're potentially fucking the whole formation because people are gonna have to like work around you basically. So you want to stick to the dots as much as possible. And like me on this LZ, when I came in, I knew that there was gonna be people coming behind me, so I shifted like north south so that there would be more space for the bird to come in. It would also fit. So just remember that when you're coming in on these LZs.
I think Novik recorded the whole thing, so we'll kind of be able to check out his Twitch channel. It was recorded on the Novik.
Yeah, we're still live streaming.
All right, yeah, we will check that out later.
On the same notes of what Wade's got there, especially for the newer pilots need to hear this. You guys, in the end, are the ones in charge of your bird. If Novix tells you to set down somewhere and you don't feel like 100% on that, you feel like you might crash and blow somebody up in an op or something, ignore what they're saying and put down somewhere that is safe for you.
Yeah. Number one responsibility is you and your bird. I'm not there.
We might come there and ask you why you did what you did, but I'm never going to get mad at you for deciding I don't think I can do that, so I'm not going to do that.
Yeah. And we're talking about a safety issue, like, you know, heavy trees, and it didn't look like that.
Or doing like an in the middle of a town landing, and you know,
power lines I didn't know about or whatever.
Yeah. Like the three of us might be landed and then the power lines start behind us and it's not where, you know, it's right where you were supposed to be landing. Make your own adjustments. We're never going to fault you for that.
And never fly over another aircraft. Because if they take off, yeah. Or you get shot up while you're flying over us, then we die too, type of thing. So.
Well, I need to take a attendance too for next Tuesday. I think they're having a JTAC qualification night. It's going to be pretty extensive, lasts for a couple of hours. If you guys can ready up for that, as soon as you see the ready up, we'll probably put that in on Monday. But keep in mind, we'll need lots of activity that night.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he wants. Really wants as many birds as he can, so that Dalton can control as many assets as possible, just to make things as chaotic and whatnot for him as possible.
I'm going to be putting out a Google Sheet with your names on it. There's going to be a grid pattern of aircraft and your suggested names for it. All of those names are going to be put into a straw poll. And obviously, if it's something...
These for call signs.
Yeah, for call signs. And if they are retarded, we're going to remove them. So... make them something decent.
Storm, I put a lot of thought in my call sign suggestions. I just want you to know ahead of time.
I will promptly ignore them and come up with something better.
So
see, Decker might be the FNG, but you're the old guy who needs to get with the times there, old man.
I am the times. What are you talking about?
Just remember who you're messing with.
Oh, yeah. No, I know. Times. I'm coming into my power, Novix. Step aside. I'm coming in.
I think we're gonna call Bradbury TVA. So he is the time variance authority. So
is that what you think?
Yeah,
it's a Loki reference.
That is a Loki reference.
Where is it?
I haven't seen the new that show yet.
Yeah. Oh, you're missing it. It's fairly good.
Is it really good?
Are you telling me, Storm, you're the only motherfucker in here that hasn't seen it yet?
Yeah, and I'm the Viking in the group, remember? I'm the Viking in the group, and I haven't seen Loki.
That's terrible.
I haven't seen it either.
Yeah,
yeah, but
What the fuck? Oh, I said CBA earlier, and CBA was like, I didn't do anything wrong.
Hey, CB, I want to comment right now for you and Decker publicly to say you guys have been kicking ass, and you got your CW2 early for that fucking reason. And Decker following suit, he's just got a little bit of time to put in to have good things happen. So, yeah, I wanted to congratulate you guys and say good job.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
I would clap, but my mic does not pick it up. Sorry.
Yeah, this is the last fucking time I'm saying it.
Now my dog's excited. This is on you.
Yeah, wait till the cat gets involved.
Yeah.
No, the cat got fed, so now she's gone somewhere and quieted down.
I'm looking at you guys, so every time, like, his cat or something, I just hear it in my right ear.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Hey, Steve, we're going to make an amendment. We're not going to have you teach anybody while you're still going through the process, too, of doing these things. I think Sunday night, you may have been a little too busy, which led to a slowdown, so we won't do that again.
Oh, the, okay.
With the drone, yeah.
Yeah, I mean,
we just want you focused on what you're doing until you get, like, those 10,000 reps in, you know? And then we'll figure out another way to get training done.
No, like,
if it makes everyone feel better, I did say that I wanted Decker with Bradbury to begin with, so.
Yeah, I don't think we're putting any fault anywhere. The only fault I can say is I wish we'd have moved into a FARP position or done the TFAR antennas ahead of time. That'd be the only thing.
And Novix showed me how to do the TFAR antennas as well as I wanted to talk to you, Bradbury. I am pretty adamant on a few things that I would like to see that I'm going to need your help with.
Okay.
Especially with this campaign, I would personally like every Sunday for the rest of the campaign to make a FARP.
Yeah, we'll make one up. We'll get a Chinook running or something and lay some pallets in there, which I think is a good thing. Gives us some extra busy time.
Yeah, we are operating out of that airfield next stop, so.
Oh, yeah, we are.
Okay. Didn't we talk about this before? I think
we did, and it didn't come to fruition running some cargo.
Because I think what happened is we were starting to...
Go for Doom.
Do you have an ETA on your pickup? Or expo?
Neg. I'll pass one to you when I get it.
Never. Did you say neg?
Negative, yep.
Negatory.
Anyways, I think what happened is we, on our end, had it all planned out, and then, like, the ground guys couldn't decide where they wanted that sort of thing and just kind of, like, ignored it until it went away.
Yeah, and I think that I kind of pushed you into keeping in mind, don't change your fucking plan, and then as soon as Geneva walked up and he changed your plan, I thought, yeah, this isn't going to go good. And that's exactly what happened to Sevia on the airdrop when he spread them out over a click and a half or two clicks. That was one of the things that, for you, being command and control of us, right, which when they board the aircraft, it doesn't matter what's on the map anymore. It's what we can deliver. So I think that Geneva had a good point later on saying, okay, all I can get out in that amount of time, right, because it's a time equation then, is about 20 people. So I think that will be the max from now on.
Roger, Dodger.
Yeah.
Maybe we should have done like two birds.
That was the original plan, was to do two birds.
Yeah. And I think we shouldn't fall into peer pressure. We shouldn't have anybody, no swinging dick motherfucker, come up from the Rangers and say, we want this shit to happen right here. You just say, fuck that. We're going to do my plan. If you don't want to get on board, stay fucking here.
Walk.
Yeah, fucking walk.
Something else I brought up at the AAR that I would like us to start doing every Sunday, whether they use it or not, run in supplies at their halfway point through their mission. If they don't use it, that's fine. It's there. But like last Sunday when they really needed those supplies and we didn't have them in, you know.
They delayed that and they kept delaying it.
Mm-hmm. So I plan on setting up a plan every Sunday for it. And, you know, I want us to take them in, whether they use them or not.
Yeah, I would tend to agree in most circumstances. We're going to have the wild cards. So we kind of on.
Oh, yeah. Everything is going to have a wild card, you know, like. Yeah.
And when you make these plans, you have to, I mean, the sign of a good leader is to be able to divulge information and say, okay, I'm going to now act on this piece of information because it's critical. That's just the piece you got to know. No one can teach that.
Mm-hmm. Was that the last campaign mission?
No.
I think next, or this coming might be the last night.
I thought there was two more left. I thought we had two at this airbase.
I think that was number 6 or 7 last time. So
was this 5 though? Maybe he's right.
Or maybe this was 5. Maybe 6.
Yeah, I thought this was 5 because I thought 4 and 5 were airdropped.
Roman numeral was 5.
Okay.
We might have two more then. I was trying to remember.
Although, speaking of having two more, I thought. Oh no, they said they're not doing a stand down in July, are they?
No, but we're not doing required. I'm not doing required training for July. I want people to enjoy their summer.
Except for you FNGs.
Yeah, it's going to be miserable for you. And then.
Fucking working.
Yeah. but other than that, Sundays are still on, so.
And I go on vacation from my real life thing on the 18th of July. I'll be gone for 10 days in Florida.
Copy.
The way
you taking your computer down with you, though, right?
My computer won't make the airplane ride. I'm sorry.
I will do my best. I will do my best to be back every Sunday at op time. So,
for those of you that can make the,
am I?
I can really hear you over here.
Hello.
You are still quiet. Good. Yep. There you go.
There he is.
Can you guys hear me
now?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it just too loud? I can get
no,
closer
no,
to the mic.
No, you're fine.
Like actually talking now. Right. Wade's like got his mouth in his chest.
Yeah, I was gonna say Wade's been staring at our feet the whole time.
He's just sad, I think.
Yeah.
Wade's
worried about the cat.
Hope that they I hope they start using phase lines more often because that'd make trying to plan for a halfway point a lot easier.
I think we're going to have to practice some convoy escort sooner or later.
Yep.
Oh, that'd be good, yeah.
I'm going to have to get somebody to drive a car or two.
Mm. So, Geneva mentioned something, and I wanted to know your guys' opinion of it. As part of, for the heavy weapons qual, part of that being shooting the big guns on, like, the Chinook and the Blackhawk here. What's your guys' opinion on that, on those being part of the heavy weapons qual?
That M134 cannot be considered a heavy weapon gun. It's so fucking
go weird. For Doom.
I wish that they weren't the mini guns and that they were
the
like
TP and Lewis is shooting at base.
Copy that. I'll pass that to Geneva.
Thank you. And he's still shooting.
Killing each other at base.
He's shooting, really?
He's trying to shoot.
Drop a lightning bolt on him. Lightning bolt on him.
Hey, Wade, were you there the night that Lemon shot Haywood in the head?
Well, that was that.
We were on one of the. Where we were at? We were on the training maps, and we had just pulled into the airfield, and Lemon's like, "Here, watch this," and just blasted Haywood in the head. He was pissed.
Remember when somebody got shot in the bird? And then, this was on Xville, it was like a hot LZ. And Hayward jumped in and then started
and took it.
Blown on.
Yeah, I remember that. Lemon was mad at him.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Absolutely. I have a lot of
Decker, you got any questions?
No, I believe we covered everything. I just, the main question I had was about that LZ there. Like I said, it did best to stay to my dots, but I also wanted to put it down where I thought was safe, like we were saying, but.
Nope, I'm actually going to hold that against you. I'm now angry at you.
All right.
The cat?
The cat?
Yeah. I'm now angry at you because you aren't here keeping my cat quiet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm a harsh ruler.
Hmm.
Yeah. I've mostly like just never been too lazy to go get her fucking fixed.
I don't have really. No, I don't think any questions. Like when I like you said, Bradbury, right. when I fly, when we fly and stuff like that, formation wise, I was just mainly a glance at it, but I fly off CVO because he was two.
That's a good thing to do. Just glance on that HMD a lot. I rarely ride the HMD. I just watch that bird in front of me, and I'm always to the
hey,
to the
Paladin.
Go for Paladin.
You're good to just bring in reinsert to Fable and just say LZ at this time.
We are nowhere near base. You're going to have to TM in manually. You have six.
Copy.
Hey Novix, let's trade our paladins for some Chinooks. Everybody needs Chinook time. Everybody needs some time.
Chinooks are gross.
We gotta figure out which Chinooks.
The RHS Chinooks ones. Yeah, we're just put six of them right there. It'd be loud.
Well, I've flown it for about 15 minutes.
Like so be careful with it.
I didn't crash.
Yeah, so. That'd be like, that would be a division. It's at least a multi-company level.
Which ones are we running here?
It's the Army W ones.
It, yeah, the W ones are the RHS ones.
They have HUD?
Haul ass.
Yes.
Yeah, they do. As long as you have the RHS HMD installed.
Yeah, I need to get the bird.
Helicopter.
It is the fastest bird in our arsenal.
They said I was going 170, pulled a hard J turn, landed it on the numbers, but I don't know.
She's fat. She's hard to turn at times.
Yeah.
The fat bitch.
CH-47.
The way Wade, I mean, not.
It's the Army W.
I keep believing I'm going to be the fucking new guy forever.
No. You got Woods is taking check ride tomorrow night.
So what happened? Why didn't he take the check ride that first night?
He is on active duty, and I think he got pulled away. So not
I guess that's reasonable.
He is very
still going to harass the shit out of him, though.
He is very formal, so you may get a berating.
Get a what?
An ass chewing from a legit ass chewer.
User in your channel timed out.
And the Army does a really good job of brainwashing people into thinking they're invincible. I mean, still, look at me. I've been out 20 years.
Yeah, and I'm still bulletproof.
Exactly.
I just encourage it, so.
The bulletproof-isms?
Yeah.
No, I work hard on treating everyone with respect, don't get me wrong. I will also make fun of the dude if, like, he goes full boot on us like he was in chat the other day.
Oh, yeah.
God, dude.
User
joined your channel. Oh, what you're talking about, right?
Yeah, that's our new walk if he gets in.
Hey, I want to remind you guys, it's kind of a policy at the 160 around here that as you represent yourself, you represent what we are. So don't engage these fuckers. Just pull away.
Either they're in our circle or they're not.
Yeah, fucker.
Is this the part where I give a hoorah? I feel like a hoorah is supposed to fit in here.
I don't know. You're an 88 mic. Do they do that?
Yeah. We used to do that shit. That or we would find our dumb bear and yell at him. If something went wrong, like you could hear throughout the building somebody yelling, Dunbar! And he would just be somewhere in the building, what did I do? Except that's about kill us all. So he's the reason that we get mad at him.
Nice.
We were moving, according to the manifest, 1.5 million pounds of explosives. And I pull up to a stoplight and he pulls up behind me directly on the train tracks with a truck full of bombs. As a train was coming full of anhydrous ammonia.
Oh, that would have
been I had to push through a red light blocking traffic to give him enough room to get off of the train track and not turn us all into a giant puddle.
Why why were you guys even stopping for stoplights?
Because we still have to follow, you know, the United States laws.
The fuck you do. You're an exception to every law.
That's what I said. That's why people were like pissed off at me, and I'm just waving as I'm driving through a fucking stoplight.
You're a moving bomb, and you have to stop.
Yeah, we had enough explosives to make a whole new Grand Canyon. Oh yeah, no. That entire mission was a shit show. Somebody, a part of our route, we ended up crossing the Hoover Dam with that.
Really?
We were supposed to be on the bridge beneath the Hoover Dam. And we went across the Hoover Dam on the way to the ammo depot in Nevada.
Oh.
Yeah.
211, this is Night Stalker.
Whoever planned it, like, it was bullshit because we went through downtown Atlanta, downtown Dallas, and downtown Las Vegas. We crossed the Hoover Dam, and we had that asshole stop on a fucking train.
They're currently in combat right now.
No, just cheating.
Oh, Novik's the cheater. So I vote his new call sign is cheater.
What was your call sign on Sunday Storm?
I was using Overlord.
Yeah, I thought maybe you ought to change that.
I was thinking we just call him Crash and then.
I mean that's that wasn't what my.
I think
like,
we need to give you one.
Yeah, that's
fine. I don't think you need to select one for yourself. You need to be given one. Delete.
I was halfway across the map and my drone disappeared.
Yeah, I was trying to teleport myself so that I could get radio comms with everyone. Because that's what
Paladin, this is Doom.
I was told to do, but I accidentally...
Doom, this is Night Stalker. Be advised. Paladins have changed aircraft. Are now Razor. Contact Razor Lead for Exville.
Copy that. What's your current pause?
Been telling that wait.
Yeah, this is a Razor flight. We are currently holding grid 104099.
104099 Razor flight and standby on ETA for Exville. Still no update on that.
Anyways,
right.
The whole Overlord thing was because I was basically trying to play AWACS, and that's a common call sign for AWACS.
Underground.
Well, I mean, I obviously wasn't in AWACS, but I was in Zeus trying to keep communications with everybody, and, you know, I expected also enemy fixed wing pushing, so I was going to start pushing up, like, bra calls and stuff for our fixed wing guys, but the fixed wing never showed up.
Hey, Bradbury,
they'd be glad I'm not fucking pissed off with them. I just laid down a bunch of Rias for their fixed wing bullcrap.
I think we should do P-51s.
I mean, I'd rock the Mustang.
Just fucking napalm the shit out of everything.
But I'm glad you brought up the fact that you might have deleted the drone because me and CV was doing fine, but I was having enough trouble. We didn't have comms. He's trying to make strikes. I'm trying to get everything going. And then
Decker,
that happened. And I said, you got to be fucking kidding. I was losing my shit.
Decker,
I was like, what
Decker called
now?
Me and said, hey, I lost my drone. I'm taking fire from this little town I just crossed over. And I was like, well, I probably got swag because I'm ready to bite the dust myself.
Yeah, I went to teleport myself out. And when I clicked, I didn't move. And I was confused. And all of a sudden, Decker comes over the radio. Hey, something happened to my drone.
I just don't understand. It's not even that hard to like teleport yourself and do.
Okay,
it
again,
like,
never done Zeus until like very recently.
Dude, what do you do is basically go to the modules, type teleport, press somewhere
you
that
don't,
you
just
want
fucking
to
right click and teleport Zeus. It's on
yeah.
the right click menu.
Yeah.
That's for like one people. That's for only you. But if you want to,
he was just teleporting
people,
himself.
Yeah, like, I'm saying this because Geneva teleported you, like, the other day as well, and you got super fucking mad about it.
Oh, that's because he control-A'd me in there. I was right in the middle of something, too.
I just don't understand.
Teach you a lesson.
It's super easy to do, and there's literally zero
chance. Well, I expect to hear your class come the end of the week there, Sevia. All
right, you know
what? I'm gonna teach you Zeus class here soon. these assholes don't know what to do half the time. So
No, 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 no. Sevia's got this. He is the resident expert.
Okay, I will actually teach that to you.
You know what I'm concerned about? There's an entire fucking squad on a hill looking down at a town, not taking fire or giving fire.
They need some fire.
We've got half the fucking town full of enemy and another two squads down below, it looks like.
I know a guy that can make more enemies appear.
She gets
you know what we could do?
Yeah.
You know what I really wanted to do it, like messing with the zoo stuff? Take control of one of those enemies that are like being absolutely dead brain and make them less dead brain.
Right.
I'm all about P versus P.
Well, yeah, so not last week, but like the week before that, I watched a single guy with a DMR shoot six guys at a checkpoint in entirely the wrong order, and not a single NPC reacted to it. User
left your channel. Dalton is down.
Nice. So, should we take in our Chinooks guns blazing for him?
Who's gonna run the guns?
Well, if you can shoot from the pilot seat, then go.
Well, you could pick your, I mean, we have six pilots here. You could pick your, three best pilots, and the other three get on guns.
So, Sevia, Wade, and Bradbury? Or...
Sure. I was actually gonna say you, Bradbury, and Wade.
No, because I hate you.
What? I was giving you a compliment.
Yeah,
pilot.
No, he's.
Yeah,
I said.
Fucking sarcastic, and I know why you talk like that.
No, I was. I was making fun of.
No, he was making fun. Yeah, that Storm. Jibe was at me.
Oh, okay.
He was thinking that I was going to be expecting that best pilot role. I was going to personally say Bradbury, Novix, and Wade, as y'all are the highest, you know, ranked people here.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I mean, you're at the bottom of the totem pole.
Well, nice. The thing is, didn't you crash, like, almost a
week
ago?
Who?
Who? No. I was gonna say, I don't know what,
There's an AI that got shot, and it's unconscious and down, and it's just holding down the trigger.
Wow. Oh,
that's some armor.
Yeah.
That's like straight Hollywood.
Yeah. Oh,
are
they
we
got...
doing that like custom helmet thing?
Oh, yeah. I was gonna say I would personally.
Does anybody know how to do that?
Novix had said that.
This idea?
I was gonna say Novix had mentioned that he might have a guy because I brought it to him. That he might have a guy who can help us retexture the helmets for our own personalized helmet.
I did buy a custom backpack.
Mm-hmm.
You bought it?
Yes, so it's gonna be in our next mod pack.
Nice. Can I see it?
Yeah, so
you can
like
see it when we implement it.
So what I'm thinking with that, with the whole personalized helmet, make it like a we can make it like a goal to reach for, like at X rank, you get a customized fucking helmet with your own, you know, colors and logo on it.
God, Storm, you're actually gonna say that?
I mean, if it's...
Yeah, because I know what you're gonna say. Oh, you're just gonna make it, CW3 and higher.
Yep.
Well, I mean, it doesn't necessarily have to be based on rank, but I mean, kind of like how when you got fully qualified, you were allowed to have the multicam vests and backpack. That was a thing I enjoyed going for. So it's like, I don't know if like we did some sort of like our own quals or something, you know, that got you a customized helmet. I think that would be badass. You know, whether it was like tests or
Storm, do you think we could? Do you think as a unit, as a Milsim unit, we would benefit from like a top pilot night? Maybe do maybe
like
do
our own
things.
Top Gun sort
yeah,
of thing.
Yeah, so we could come up with a scoring system. Say,
okay, I think that would be badass, and then we could sit there and lord that over each other. Like, hey, I'm the better pilot, and
so
then
if you've done a pinnacle landing,
couple months,
you
get a chance
points.
To.
If you've done, you know, a J hook in with a Black Hawk that get you 20 points or something, some sort of scoring system. Yeah.
And then it's just a meaningless trophy for fun that we could try to wrestle from each other, you know, every so often.
So that I can beat Storm's ass.
Yeah. And when you beat my ass, you'd get the trophy, and it would be pretty cool. And you could, like, lord that over me until Bradbury comes and sits you the fuck down.
Do you need the training to pick us up? We're about to end act, so we could teleport if you don't.
Tillman will come pick him up time now. We've seen HLZ.
Doom, we can pick you up time now at that LZ we dropped you at.
Yeah, we're not going to be able to run over there in time. Seems kind of pissed, so if you don't need the training, then you probably want to teleport, to be honest.
Yeah, sounds good. And they can TP back.
We're probably going to have to move to the west side of the town.
They can TP back. We'll RTB.
Okay.
Jim, you're good to TP. We'll just fly back.
Copy.
All right. Well, let's head on back.
Wait, do we have to fly in AFM when we're doing that?
No.
Okay, then I will beat I will definitely beat AFM Stone's ass.
I would say AFM definitely has to be some sort of multiplier.
Oh my god.
Yep, this one has HMDs on. Great.
Did you think it didn't?
Apparently they TP'd everybody.
Yep, apparently we're getting TP'd instead of continuing our training. That's cool.
That's cool.
All right, everybody in the Zeus plot, sign up for a class on Friday. I am sick of this shit.
Medic coming through.
Take your nods off.
I need a medic. I am.
Everyone take your nods off, please. Take your nods off, please.
Air, go to the north.
You don't need a medic,
you're fine.
Everyone take your
nitrous
off.
All right.
Yeah, you know what? Okay.
Nods.
My eyes.
All right, everybody in whisper. Huddle up in whisper.
Huddle up.
Is there anything you guys want to practice, Bradbury?
I think we're good.
Okay. Storm.
Nah, I'm fine.
Wade.
Oh, who got found the head? I found the head too.
Okay. I think you guys did good tonight. I liked everything overall. Storm, your AFM is mediocre.
Yep, I appreciate that.
And other than that, dude, I really liked everything else. Bradbury?
Yeah, so we'll come up with a format, I think, for Top Gun trophies. Right. We'll have a Top Gun Chinook, right, Top Gun Little Bird, a Top Gun Black Hawk.
Form up.
Sounds good. We'll I will have Reese make some icons so that we can add those. And so yes, you can lose them. If you leave the unit, go to reserves, or whatever the case may be,
it's going to be. I personally think the whole Top Gun thing, only one of us at a time, like Sevia could have the Black Hawk one, and I can't have the Black Hawk one until I do better than him.
Yes.
That way we can make it like an inner competition against each other.
Yep.
So at least you know your place.
Yep, we'll come up with a format and a scoring system. We'll get everybody approval on it, and then we'll have a launch day.
Do we want to do one Top Gun trophy for everything, or do we want... Want to do
different low birds, Blackhawk and Chinook or something like that.
Well, how about one rotary, one fixed wing?
I don't want fixed wing in this type of thing.
Okay,
at all.
So just rotary. So why don't we just do one?
I was just trying to incorporate everybody as a each
like
bird will have its different
birds,
assets.
Okay.
Now my feeling on it is a little bird will be able to do things a Chinook could never do.
So
okay.
Maybe we
and vice versa.
Or one.
I think it's going to be tough, though. I think when we design it, it'll be like, oh my god, this is tough.
Yeah.
I would also like to see some things that, you know, we don't get to do as much, like making sure that there are gun runs on part of that, you know, like trying to hit things accurately and efficiently and trying to get into tight, you know, landings quickly.
Pinnacle landings.
Yeah. You know, the things that you see all of the badass military pictures involving.
Yep, yep. Time on target, sling loading, all that shit.
Yep. I mean, you can get penalties.
So
yeah, go ahead.
If I beat Storm, do I get his place?
If you want to be XO, I'll go and do something else, man. I mean, I'm fine, you know, and then I'll just, you know, go back to my F-16 and my A-10, and I'll be just as happy of a camper.
Yeah,
I think we're going to have a T-38.
Oh, yeah. That could be fun as well.
I'm so excited.
He just can't hide it.
I'm so excited.
All right. Good job, guys. That's all I got. All
right. Sounds good. Good night, guys.
See you.
Guten Tag.